A new scientific paper attempts to shed light on a mystery at Jupiter that continues to baffle space scientists. Among the countless surprises that NASA's Juno space probe has revealed since it entered Jupiter's orbit in 2016, perhaps none has proved more puzzling than the discovery of multiple cyclones, which appear fixed and unmoving at each of Jupiter's poles. Nothing in the standard theoretical toolkits of atmospheric and planetary science predicted nor can explain the phenomena. As described in a recent phys.org report, photos of the planet's north pole showed that there are 8 cyclones surrounding the central cyclone directly over the pole. All 8 are in close proximity, and all are nearly equidistant from the central cyclone and are arranged in an octagonal pattern. At this time, it is not clear if the cyclones rotate around the center. There is a similar arrangement at the southern pole, only there are just 5 cyclones, shaped as a pentagon. The report acknowledges, such behavior is of course unheard of here on Earth. Cyclones take shape, travel around for a while, and then dissipate. Such behavior has left researchers scrambling to come up with a reasonable explanation for what they have observed. In a new paper published in the journal Nature Astronomy, a team of scientists has used data and images from the Juno probe to determine the winds and direction of the cyclones. As noted in the phys.org report, the team has proposed that there is, quote, an anticyclonic ring of winds that move in the opposite direction of the cyclones, which is what keeps them in place. And while that may hold true, the team was unable to find signatures of convection, which would have helped to explain how heat was being used to fuel the cyclones. They acknowledge that much more work will need to be done to fully explain the behavior of Jupiter's cyclones. The irony of this hypothesis is evident to those familiar with the groundbreaking work of Thunderbolt's colleague, Dr. Donald Scott. It was a few years ago that Dr. Scott first published his mathematical modeling of the structure of a Birkeland current, which could be visualized as counter-rotating cylindrical shells. In past interviews, Dr. Scott noted that counter-rotational patterns can be seen in the vortexes at the poles of the gas giants, Jupiter and Saturn. Indeed, counter-rotational wind movements associated with Jupiter's cyclones would not be surprising if incoming Birkeland currents are contributing to the phenomena. In more recent years, Dr. Scott has closely followed Earth's wind patterns, and as he described in his April 2, 2022 Thunderbolts video, he has found clear visual evidence that our planet's polar wind patterns are driven from the outside, and not by any surface or internal earthbound processes or dynamos. This evidence suggests that the main outside source of these polar winds is the varying strength and direction of the Birkeland current stream of electrically charged particles. However, the aforementioned Nature Astronomy paper looks to, quote, shallow water models rather than plasma physics to explain the Jovian cyclones. Nor is this the first time that space scientists have looked to fluid dynamics to resolve the anomalous appearance of fixed geometric patterns in the upper atmosphere of a gas giant planet. For decades, the hexagon at Saturn's south pole has puzzled planetary scientists. Several years ago, researchers succeeded at producing similar forms through simple fluidic experiments, providing an explanation that many astronomers have favored. However, more recent scientific discoveries have definitively pointed away from the mechanical, fluidic explanation. In 2018, scientists using images obtained by NASA's Cassini spacecraft observed an unexpected, towering vortex far above the famous hexagon. A Science Alert report on the observation stated, there's something strange over Saturn's north pole. A tremendous structure towering high above the clouds indicates that the planet's peculiar hexagonal formation is much, much bigger than was initially apparent. One of the investigators said of the discovery, as the polar vortex became more and more visible, we noticed it had hexagonal edges and realized that we were seeing the pre-existing hexagon at much higher altitudes than previously thought. The problematic nature of this discovery is noted in the article, which states, since wind conditions change dramatically with altitude, the fact that the hexagon shape persists so much higher than the cloud tops is a baffling conundrum. In other words, the persistence of the hexagonal feature hundreds of kilometers above the clouds was a clear indication it is being driven by energy from above and cannot be explained by simple fluid dynamics. Is it a coincidence, then, that hexagons and other polygonal or octagonal forms are produced in plasma discharge? Consider the side-by-side images on your screen. On the left are vortices of an electron beam etched onto a carbon witness plate. On the right are vortices of an electron beam photographed on a fluorescent screen. The hexagonal form is a distinct feature of a well-documented plasma phenomenon called the dioketron instability. And the phenomenon observed in the laboratory is remarkably scalable, as explained by Dr. Anthony Parad in Physics of the Plasma Universe. The vortices of the dioketron instability are found to occur over 12 orders of magnitude in beam current. This mechanism was first introduced to explain auroral curtains by Hannes Alfvén. As we've noted many times, the chief proponent of the electric universe, physicist and Thunderbolt science advisor Wall Thornhill, made an outrageous prediction with respect to the Saturnian hexagon. In 2005, Thornhill analyzed the mysterious hotspot in the vortex at Saturn's south pole. The hotspot puzzled planetary scientists because, as described by the Keck Observatory, both the distinct boundary of a warm polar vortex some 30 degrees latitude from the southern pole and a very hot tip right at the pole were completely unexpected. Thornhill wrote of this feature, "Its compactness is due to the electromagnetic pinch effect where it enters Saturn's atmosphere." He then stated, "The electric universe also predicts, experimentum crucis, that both poles should be hot, not one hot and the other cold." In 2008, the Cassini spacecraft confirmed the astonishing prediction. Astonishing because the freezing cold North Pole had been deprived of sunlight for more than 12 years. Thornhill explained, "The polar hotspot and long-lived hexagonal feature result from a continuous electric current flowing from the sun into the pole of Saturn." Indeed, in stark contrast to the conventional view of the Sun as an isolated body powered by internal thermonuclear reactions, the electric universe proposes that the Sun is primarily an electrical phenomenon, at the focus of a galactic glow discharge. In this view, electric currents flowing from the Sun to planets has implications for many atmospheric phenomena, including the tremendous winds, stupendous magnetic fields, and X-ray and temperature anomalies of the gas giants, as well as jet streams and weather patterns on Earth. For decades, Thornhill has argued that weather systems on Earth are primarily electrical phenomena, and both on our planet and elsewhere in the solar system, the evidence of the Sun's connection to weather and atmospheric phenomena continues to grow. As we reported in 2014, scientists in the UK discovered the completely unexpected ability of solar storms to trigger dramatic lightning on Earth. And in fact, at Jupiter, scientists recently discovered a surprising influence of the Sun on tremendous heating and temperature anomalies. As noted in the October 1, 2022 Science Alert article, a planet-sized heat wave has been found in Jupiter's atmosphere. A heat wave the size of 10 Earths has been discovered rippling through Jupiter's atmosphere. It was 130,000 kilometers across and a scorching 700 degrees Celsius, traveling at speeds up to 2,400 meters per second away from the Jovian North Pole. And this, scientists say, could resolve one of the more perplexing mysteries about our solar system's biggest planet: why it's so much hotter than models predict. As the article explains, planetary scientists have long attempted to attribute this anomalous heating to Jupiter's auroras, although the spectacular X-ray auroras themselves are not well explained in standard astronomy. However, a team of researchers discovered that when Jupiter was hit by a large solar storm, they noted a synchronous enhancement of so-called auroral heating. The Science Alert report acknowledges, "Jupiter is not the only planet in the solar system that is hotter than it should be. Saturn, Neptune, and Uranus are all hundreds of degrees hotter than solar heating can account for." While planetary scientists increasingly have no choice but to recognize the role of electric currents in planetary systems, as they have for many years at both Jupiter and Saturn, they still view the electric currents as byproducts of localized phenomena in closed systems. However, just as Thornhill successfully predicted the hallmarks of electric currents flowing into the poles of Saturn, we predict that no hypothesis based on simple fluidic dynamics will explain the fixed cyclones on Jupiter. Rather, These dramatic phenomena are testimony to the electrical circuitry that pervades our solar system, and indeed, our entire electric universe.